We meet in Lisbon at a pivotal juncture for the alliance. At the NATO summit in June, Allied heads of state and government opened a new chapter in the transatlantic relationship and NATO adaptation toward 2030. The decision to revise NATO's strategic concept is a critical and necessary step, and the NATO Parliamentary Assembly looks forward to contributing our ideas in substantive ways. The security environment has shifted fundamentally since the last strategic concept was adopted back in 2010. Allies must confront today's world of renewed systemic competition together, firmly rooted in transatlantic solidarity. Russia, China, and others seek actively to undermine the rules-based international order, promoting parallel norms, institutions, and alliances, and proponents of illiberalism try to weaken our societies from within. We must respond by rededicating ourselves to our shared democratic values. These must be anchored within NATO's strategic concept and, as we have proposed as an assembly, in an actual center within NATO for democratic resilience. We must also critically reflect upon our engagement in Afghanistan, which came to a painful, difficult, but necessary end after almost two decades. Our experience holds important lessons the alliance must draw on to ensure NATO refines and refocuses its approach to the evolving external threats. The next 4 days are an opportunity to discuss these important questions and to help shape the future of the alliance itself. We will also tackle the full spectrum of the transatlantic security agenda. Let me highlight a few of those key topics. Bolstering the resilience of our societies in the face of growing challenges such as disinformation and climate change. The need to maintain defense spending, maintain NATO's technological edge, and to continue to work toward fairer burden sharing within NATO. The ongoing instability across the Middle East and North Africa. And NATO's efforts to support and strengthen arms control and disarmament. I so look forward to exchanging with all of you during the first in-person assembly session in almost 2 years. And finally, I want to thank our Portuguese hosts for organizing this landmark session during a pandemic in close cooperation with their health authorities. Thank you all, and let's have a productive and successful annual session.